Alrighty, well, here I am in my home in Japan, Fujiyoshida, and today I'm going to be doing something that is very traditional Japanese, and that is removing the paper off of a Japanese-style door, and it's called a shoji door. And I'm going to be doing it here in the washitsu, which is the Japanese-style room. Get this camera set up here. All right. And so the first thing that you have to do when you're going to be putting on new paper is get this old paper off. And so I got some just a little thing of water here and a wet washcloth. And I'm just going to dip this in here. Now you just want to go wet the edges because that's where the glue is that is here on the sun. The sun is the wooden skeleton that you're going to see underneath the shoji paper when this paper comes off. And so, first thing you have to do, and this whole thing just takes patience because if you don't, it's paper and it's going to rip. So, once you rip it, it takes a lot longer. So, right now I'm just gently wetting the sun or the wooden, I guess you could say, spines inside the door here. Sort of like the skeleton underneath the paper. Underneath the skin, and you know, you have to let it soak in for a few minutes. Now, this is obviously a Japanese tradition that's been handed down to me from generations and generations in my family, my Japanese family, of course. But it's something that needs to be done. If you could see, this here, the papers are two different papers, so they're discolored. Over here on this edge, it didn't even reach to the end. Didn't even reach to the end of the shoji door. So, yeah, it was long overdue for a change here. So, like I said, just wetting down the spine here, the sun. Today is Friday, the 28th of October here in Japan. And we just came over for a long needed visit. Corona had pretty much the world shut down for a few years there. And so on the 11th of October of this month, they made it so. They loosened the restrictions. There's no quarantine restrictions for foreigners coming into Japan. And so we bought our tickets and planned a trip, and here we are. All right. Right, let's see how that is. I think I got all the sun wet. Put this off to the side here. And then, like I say, you just gotta be patient. Maybe push from the bottom. See if it comes up. There we go. Not quite on that one. We'll check on this others. See, it's a different kind of paper, so. This bottom lighter paper soaked through a lot easier. Still can use a bit more. Patience. Sometimes I just squeeze water out from this little rag that I'm using to wet this. And you obviously don't want to get it on the inside of the paper just because it makes the paper that much easier to tear. And so you want to just, as much as possible, keep it on this on, keep it on the ribs, and voila. That's the first strip. And now, that's another thing, is typically these aren't done in strips. It's done in one big swooping piece, if you will. All right. Soak up some of this excess water. All right, now to this one, who's being a little stubborn, little thicker paper. No, I don't know, to some people, you know, stuff like this is just so satisfying. Take off here, and I know that people geek out about this, but I'm not a man with a lot of patience, so this is trying my patience here for sure. But any job worth doing is worth doing right the first time. So even if I don't have the patience, it's still a necessary part of the job. Boom. All right. So pretty much here we have the clean sawn, the clean ribs, if you will. Now there's still some paper on it here. If it isn't too much, that's okay. You just don't want, like, you know, anything that's going to be a noticeable difference underneath the paper that you're about ready to install. So, all right. Okay. So get that water out of the way, just so I don't spill it. It's my father-in-law back here in our washitsu, our Japanese style room. Okay, so this here is the special glue and the applicator that is made for shoji door. It has this little gap on it, and so you just put that over the sawn and kind of run your strip of glue. Now, it works great on the sawn, but on the edges, it's a little different, because the edges, of course, won't fit in that little groove. So you just take it off, and it's two piece applicator here. Can't see that behind my red shirt, but anyway. And again, did I mention this takes patience? Okay. Start on this side. And you just want to run a very small bead of glue right on the top of each of these sawn. You don't want to gob a lot of glue on there, because it's only going to take a little, and the less glue you use, the quicker it dries as well. Steady hand, drag that all along there, put a little more here, add a little gap, and you don't want a lot of gaps in your glue bead, Because air will pass through that, and eventually it'll take the paper off, especially if you have a lot of humidity in the house or in the weather. Okay, got those. Go the cross ones. By the way, don't fast forward this because you'll miss the important part. I'm kidding. The important part's my sense of humor, I guess. But it's going to be out there for all posterity to learn how to do these traditional Japanese shoji door. All right, then from here, you just have to like eyeball it and do it around the edges. It's not as easy because you don't have that little guide thing on there. So just take your time, run it along the edge to get the stuff done. Of course, you want to be careful where you're putting your hands up and down, because if you put it on top of one of these san and put your weight on it, it'll snap right through. Okay, and last but not least, okay, so what happened there is my applicator, actually somewhere along the line, pulled up some of the old paper, which is just fine if that happens. Just make sure you get it off the door before you replace it. Boy. That's better. Okay. Once you got your glue on there, then I'm just checking that there's not any very big noticeable gaps. And, move that off to the side. Okay, so now you have your shoji door paper. This is one of the hardest parts of it right here, because this you have to apply it straight the first time, or it's not going to be conducive to successful shoji door paper laying. And that's the hardest part, is to get this thing straight. There are different techniques, but again, that's where the patience comes into factor there. So I put one edge on as straight as I can, and then I basically just roll it down the bad boy. Okay. Now, one thing you can keep in mind and remember is that this paper and the glue on it, it does become somewhat transparent as it dries, and so if you get a little bit of glue on the paper side where you're gonna be, you know, that's not on the sun, then you'll be okay. Now these right here are just little tape strips, and I'm gonna put it on this corner just to hold this paper down there. So when I roll this down like so, it will just stay as straight as I can keep it. Okay, not the best job, but I think acceptable. Okay. Definitely not 100% perfect, but as you can see now, we do have the whole paper covering all of the windows on the shoji door. Then you take a razor or a cutter knife or something, and with a steady hand as you can possibly manifest, you want to, in one sweeping cut, all the way along the edge, okay? So, and not into the window, if at all possible, for obvious reasons. And don't have a blade standing up. Have it laying down so it's flat. A sharp blade is best. So it just cuts straight, flat, perfect, all the way. Okay. One straight, non-stopping cut. That's the key. Okay. Let's see if I can do that down to this side too. All right. Right on the edge. Here we go. Don't need to press hard, because you are cutting wet paper as it is anyway. So, all right. Now here, very carefully, pull away the cut strip. And you want to pull it kind of down and out. That's for two reasons. It helps keep the line straight, but also it helps pull the paper here tighter onto the sun, onto the windows, and it makes for a nice and tight paper shoji door fit. Okay. Tear that piece off. Now here's a bit different, because you're starting from this edge over here, so you, obviously you can't pull down. There we go, let's start from this end. If you need to put your hand on top of the paper to get it going, that's fine. Patience becomes a factor here too. There we go. Because the what's happened is the paper does start, or the glue does start to dry underneath there. So patience. Final area I have to make sure it's on there. Just cut it across here. so that it will not tear. There we go. Okay. And there you go. So now you got your roll of shoji paper. One roll of shoji paper does about four doors. I have about five to do. But now, as you can see, now yes, you can still see the lines in there because that glue has not dried yet. But you turn that around and put it up against a wall like that. Yeah, looks pretty good. Looks a lot better. There's no gaps. This glue still hasn't dried up here in the corners. But other than that, fairly good quality shoji door paper application. Incidentally, the shoji door and the tatami mat are exactly the same dimensions. That was just because after they made tatami mats at first, and they needed to have like some design, and so they thought, you know, we lay down on the tatami here and we fit just fine. If we made a door that same dimension, we should be able to fit through it. So just a little known fact that the tatami mat and the shoji door are actually the same height and width. But they're not interchangeable. You cannot pick up a tatami mat and put it where the door should go. It just doesn't work that way. Anyway, hope that was some help. And, yeah, thanks for tuning in.